Yeah, Martin wants to speak today. I mean, my name is Dr. Devlakar, asked me to come and talk. So I'll give a very short one. So from just now you've been hearing about how to balance your life as a Christian and a student or studying. But I will give one of the most important things is how you carry yourself as a Christian. Because what you're carrying is the name of the word Christian. So you're saying that you believe in Jesus. Sometimes we don't really understand the name of the word Christian. We can go to school, we can act how we want, but we don't actually think about how that reflects on ourselves, how people view us. So, to be a true Christian, the person must change. So how you act now will reflect on how you act in 10 years, 20 years. Acts chapter 2, 37 to 39, it says, show that Christians must repent and walk in a different way of life. When you are a Christian, you're not supposed to follow the way of the world. Even though the way of the world may look interesting at all times, even though the way of the world looks a fun way of doing things, it's amusing obviously, but sometimes you have to think in your heart, is this what God wants me to do? And when you see your friends all, maybe I don't, my friends all, some of them like to go clubbing, some of them love to go clubbing, smoking, drinking, and sometimes I look at them, of course it looks fun, but I have to tell myself, is this what God wants me to do? Is this what a Christian should do? Sometimes it's hard to say no. It's very hard to say no sometimes. But you have to, if you are a true Christian, you will tell yourself, I can say no. Okay? And one more thing is, in Romans chapter 10, verse 9 to 10, it says, if you confess with your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. You all, I know you all know that Jesus is alive, right? And Jesus died for you. The thing is, how much do you really understand what he did for you? The suffering that he went through for you? You know that Jesus died on the cross. You thought about it, I know. But do you understand how much of a humiliation and pain that God went through to save you from your sins? He died on the cross. He was tortured, humiliated in every way possible. The most cruel way a man can die. Sometimes we don't really understand that. We just see it as God died for my sins. That's it. I'm sorry. But what he really did for you is what you call love. And that's what a true Christian should do is love. And I'm not talking about the movie love. You see in the K-drama, you see in the movies. That love is human love. What God did for us is the true love. A love that cannot be comprehended. A love that only can happen through God. And so he asked us to share the love with each other. He says in the Bible, you should love your neighbor as you love yourself. I'm not telling you that you should love everyone no matter what they do. You should love everyone in a way that you don't hate anyone. You don't fight anyone. Let's say someone argues with you. Why are you fighting back with them? There's no reason to. You are just creating more problems for everyone else. So find it in your heart to love. Love as in love your neighbor as yourself. And that's all I want to say. Thank you.